In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how I drew this elevation. And in the previous video, I had shown you how I made this elevation along with all the relevant keys, reference lines, grids, and other things. So let's begin. Okay, so the first thing that you'll need to do is, as I had explained earlier, you will need to rotate your copy of floor plan, clean out everything from it, and then rotate the side from which you wish to draw your elevation. So in this case, I'll do this. I did not delete this elevation the last time. And before we get into this, let me just show you what this is. Now, this is what you call a basic shop drawing. A shop drawing is a fabrication drawing which a fabricator or a contractor will create to instruct its employees or another fabrication company as to how we can do construction. More of this in the following videos. So now that you have rotated your floor plan, what we will do is type XL for X line, similar process as earlier, and simply move this board to this side over here, like so. Now the next thing that we will do is copy the lines to create a profile of your walls and other features. Now, as I had said earlier, you will need to take this as your ground level, and then you'll need to offset at a distance of 750 mm from the highest point. Then from there, you'll need to offset a 150 mm thick slab. That's your floor slab. And then from the finished floor slab, you will offset a distance of 2.4 meters or 2400 millimeters. So now that is done, you draw yourself a rectangle, like so. And you draw yourself another rectangle, not from this point, but from this point. From there, go down in a diagonal fashion. Now you'll draw yourself another rectangle from there to a half of this. And I'll show you why I said to a half of it. Okay, so let me just bring back all my ribbons. I used a clean screen, which you can either enter and exit from this part over here, or you can do command now. I mean, from the keys. I like to use the keys, so I'll use the keys for this one. So that's Control 0 to get all my ribbons back. And then if the command line goes missing, you just do a Control and 9. You need to press them simultaneously. Okay. So now that you have done that, what we will do is I will explain to you why I have created this at a half. Now that's not going to be at a half. It's just going to be 50 millimeter drop from this existing finish level, so that if anytime it rains, the water will not protrude into this, and the water will not actually penetrate into this floor. It will go stay on this floor and then go down. So I'm using 150 mm thick finished slab on for the main building, because I've consulted my engineer accordingly. And then I'll use a 125 mm or 100 mm slab for the porch. So from this line, not the top line, from this line, I'll just do an offset of 100 mm and press enter. Then I got my 100 mm thick finishing line. From there, what I'll do is delete these, and all the unnecessary lines that are there, you can also delete them. So for this case, I'll just delete all these because they are unnecessary at the current moment. And then what I'll do is put these into their respective layers. So this is for the elevation. So we click on the layers, this drop down arrow. Then we click on the elevation paint, or we can say elevation outline. So for this, we'll put it to elevation paint. But since I did not set up the layer correctly, what I'll do is I'll just change the color of the layer, and I'll put it to a number 7, or we can say number 5 blue, and there you go. You see how easy it is to work with the layers. So now what I'll do is I will finish off my building, I mean bring my building into its place. Then I'll draw another rectangle, and that will be for the porch. Now it may look funny for the time being, but you'll see when it finishes, it'll look really nice. Now I'll move this reference line up to the finished floor level, and then I'll do an offset of 2.1 meters. That is the lintel level and the top height of the window. Now I'll take this line and I'll simply copy them to where my windows are. So I select this, copy here and paste here. Paste there. And like I said, you do not need to copy multiple times if your windows are in the same elevation. Since window 2, there are two window 2s and two window 3s, I just have to do one X line. And I'll explain again why I've done that. So then I'll go to my windows that I had already drawn in a previous video. And I'll copy the window that I need. So I need a window 2 and I need a window 3. As you can see that I have already set up my windows, so that I don't have to struggle in the future whilst drafting. So copy all of the windows that are required for that particular elevation, and simply bring them and just paste them anywhere. Now what I'll do is move them, or you can just copy and just paste it directly to the point like so, and then you can move this one into its place. Now you must be wondering why I said not to do another two extra lines. So this is the reason. You select this, then you type CO for copy, press enter. Then you select this window's base point, middle O, a corner point. That is window 2, and match it up with the next window 2. So that you get a nice and consistent window. Similarly with this. Select the object, type copy or recall if you want to recall by pressing enter. Then just copy this and bring it over here like so. What we'll do is we'll delete this line, and as you can see that our elevation has started to take its shape. Okay. Now there's one more thing that I told you earlier, that we will determine our roof pitch from this angle. And let me show you what I actually meant. Since I've set up my grids over here, what I'll do is simply just copy this grid, this bottom grid, and this top grid. And then what I'll do is do CO for copy. Copy this from there. And paste it over there like so. Now that is our roof height for this elevation. Because since this is one roof, so we don't need to worry much about this. We'll just put a column here, which I've already consulted my engineer about. And then we'll put the roof on it. So I'll just copy one of the rectangles and rotate it. Don't worry about the dimensions. You just set it up in the right place, as I'm doing here. Now, this is the underline of the roof. So what we will do is we'll click on this and move it up. Now since this one was 100 and I'm using a 200, what I'll do is select this hot grip, pull it outside and enter a distance of 100. So that is my column there. Now usually I do pretty fast talk, but for videos like this, instructional videos, I take it a step slow so that people do not get lost whilst I'm explaining things to them. So my the overhang of the building was 600 mm. And then what I'll do is I'll offset one line by 600 mm. Then I'll click on this line, type MI for mirror. Find one of the center points, or you just do a M2P. And then just mirror it to the other side. Now you can see that you have a 600 mm diameter overhang. So now that is done, we'll do a REC. We'll turn on our roof layer first. And then we type REC for rectangle. Click on one corner and click on the other diagonal corner. Then you can delete this grid. It's completely unnecessary now. We'll need that later on, but not for now. Then I'll type an RE, I mean, then I'll type a PL for polyline, then press enter. Click on this and move this outwards. Do an offset of 150 mm. Press enter. means do your offsets. Now type PL for polyline. Put one here and just copy this one to the other side, or you can mirror it. But in this case, I'll just do a copy. And then what I'll do is simply select all of these and just type J for join and then press enter. Now this is the flashing. The roof will have flashing at the top over here, not at the bottom here. This is going to be the gutter line and then the two sides over here. Select one of the corners and just move them out and place them into the corner. Or you can further complete these flashing by simply putting a hatch in it. Now, as you can see that when I did the join command, my lines did not join properly. This is where the fillet with zero radius comes in. So to get the fillet with a zero radius, what you do is type F, then you type space bar or enter, then you type R space bar or enter, then you enter your radius, which should be zero, not one or two, and press enter. If you wish to do multiple corners with this, you click on multiple, and if you wish to do one, don't click on multiple. So we'll select multiple, then we just go around with the corners. Like so. So now that you can see, you have a perfectly joined line. So what we'll do is we'll just simply add the hatch inside so that it looks like a flashing. And I'll just select a solid hatch and maybe use a number 9 gray. Like so. Now select this line and then type DR, that's for draw order. Click on draw order. Select that line, type DR for draw order, then press enter. And move it up to the front. Now as you can see that this rectangle is still left, so what we will do, we will draw a hatch that represents a roof. Now do not put this flashing up here. You'll need to cover the entire roof with cladding first, roofing iron cladding first, and then you'll put your flashings. That is how a roof construction is sequenced. You need to first cover the roof with cladding and then you put the flashings, respected flashings, accordingly. Then you type H for hatch. Remember, you have to do this once only. You select any one of your hatches that you like. Don't worry about the color, don't worry about the pattern. And hatch the inside of that roof. So once you have done that, you can change the scale so that it has a nice color like so, but these lines will have to be made straight. So I'll use a scale of 30 so that it looks neat. Then what I'll do is select this hatch. Now note to yourself that hatches make your drawing slow, so try to do your hatches in the end of your drafting and keep on pressing Ctrl S as you go at every 5 minute interval. Then what I'll do is select this hatch and adjust the angle over here so that it becomes 90. Or you can change the angle up here. You can enter your values up here. There you go. Now that looks like a realistic corrugated iron roof, and you can specify in your keys and your structural drawings as to what kind of roof you're using, a XRW, Ultra, or CGI, whichever one you think is right. So for this one, we'll customize this one because it looks untidy. Now what I like to do is simply, for the solid background, I like to put it as a 255 white, and then for the line in the corrugations, I like to use a dark color. I can either use magenta or I can use white. Now don't worry if it shows up like this. If you're using a number 7 for this outline, it will print as black, and let me show you what I mean. There you go. Now that you can see that it's actually showing up accordingly, properly. So what I do is, I'll show you what I was speaking about earlier. I'll just explain to you the two H's. So you basically select your H, and then I said that the corrugations to be of number 7 white. This is number 7 white. And its background you can leave it as blank, but I like to use 255 white. Now 255 white will not print as black, it will print as white. But number 7 white will always print as black. So keep that in mind. Now that you have done that, we'll go back to our model space. Select your flashings and move them into place. Like I said, sequencing. Cladding first, then the flashing. Now, if you see that your hatch is a bit transparent, you select on this and you either change the value to 0 over here or you use this. I mean, you use this arrow and just put it to a 0. Like so. After you've done that, do RE for region, then press enter. Then what I'll do is simply bring in my grid and the other things. So like I said, one will be your template, what you'll create the other one with this one. So what I'll do is I'll copy this CO for copy, select a base point like so. And then just bring it over here and paste it in here like so. So what you can do is simply remove the ones that are unnecessary, or you can move them up and adjust them. Like so. Then I'll do an X line and just draw it slightly outside the roof. I'll select all these lines in one go. And then I'll select this plane. Then I'll do EXTEND for extend. And I'll simply just extend them either one by one, or I'll just do a window select. Keep your selection cycling on so that you know what you are selecting and what is actually going on, because it will get confused and ask you which line you wish to extend. Now it is a bit annoying, but it's always best to use a selection cycling. Now that you have done that, what you can do is simply copy all your grids from here and just paste them up there like so. Now that is all the time that I have for this video. I will show you how to complete this elevation in the next video, and then I'll also try to get rid of all these unnecessary things. Thank you very much for watching. If you like my contents, please like and subscribe to my channel, and let me know if you have any queries or questions via comments. Thank you very much.